If you have always wondered what's inside those pitcher and faucet water filters, well, wonder no more. We have cut apart a used up per pitcher water filter to show you what is inside. Water was no longer flowing through it. Most of these filters have three stages of filtering in them. Two physical stages, first and third, and a second stage, which is an active carbon filtering stage wedged in between the two physical stages. The first stage is just a crude sediment filter designed to keep large particles out of the rest of the filter. The third stage is a pleated accordion style filter that takes out the finer sized particles and is made similar to air filters you'll find in most automobiles, furnaces, and older vacuum cleaners. The second stage is what does most of the work, with the carbon absorbing many of the impurities and much of the contamination commonly found in water. The second stage also contains little styrofoam balls like this. These styrofoam balls do not seem to have any water filtering purpose, but they do slowly make their way down from the second to the third filter stage along with filtered water. As we look at the third stage of the filter, we see that it is generally in a very good shape. In fact, it looks so clean that if it was in your car, you wouldn't even think of replacing it. The first water filter stage is not bad either. We're on a well here, and our water is rich in iron, which explains the discoloration. This house also has a whole house sediment filter, which takes out all the particles down to 2 microns. So we don't expect to see much sediment collected by this first stage pre-filtering, and we don't. Looking at the active carbon media, you can't really tell how much more capacity to take up impurities it has remaining, but it really has not had that much water pass through it, and the water that did go through it is from a very deep and clean source, so I would venture to guess that it would be perfectly fine for a very long time still. So what is causing all these filters to plug up and stop filtering? To answer this question, let's take a closer look at the third stage pleated filter. If you look close enough, you will see that the inner layer of this pleated filter is non-porous, except that it has little holes in it, and all of these holes are now plugged up with those little styrofoam balls we showed you earlier. So as these little balls come down from the second filtering stage down to the third, they get caught inside the little holes and clog the pleated filter entirely. In other words, this filter is designed to fail before it can ever reach, under normal circumstances, anywhere close to its full filtering capacity. And this is how P&G and its competitors in the water filtration business make sure that they can sell you more of the consumables than you really need and would otherwise buy.